Hello, welcome to another episode of my blind playthrough of Elden Ring. My name's Hansel. I'm doing a long, slow, kind of exploratory blind playthrough of Elden Ring. It's just trying to really discover all the game's mechanics, the lore, and just try to have an unspoiled experience, basically going through it. So, in this episode, I'm going to try to get past that first, the first gatekeeper boss, the one on the way to the Storm Castle or something, I think it's called. But I've been off screen. I've been doing a little bit of grinding just to get enough ruins to level up one more time, and probably also strengthen my scimitar as well. So I'm just going to do that now and then head off and try to beat that boss. I also noticed there's some new characters here at the round table, so I'll talk to them as well, but I'll do that on the way back. Let's go. Anything I want to buy rather than living up. Memory stone increases memory slots. Maybe. Night helm. Ruin art. Grant the blessing of an equipped great ruin upon use. Okay, I don't know what that means. No, I don't think there's anything I need to buy. It might be quite nice to have a spear for when I'm on horseback, maybe? I'm not sure. But no, I don't think there's anything I need to buy. I'll just level up my, or augment my sword.
Hiding. I took you for dead. No matter, it's all to say. Out your arms.
Okay, let's strengthen this scimitar to plus 3, and that's a. Okay, and that gives it more dex scaling as well. Great. I haven't been down here either. This is another. Oh, that's a. No. Ah, don't have one. Okay. There's one for sale upstairs for 4,000. So, do I want to buy that instead of leveling up? No, I'll just level up. Should we go another to vigor? Or just more damage? Okay.
Be sure to tell me if you meet a young woman named Lanya.
Sounds like the King of the North, doesn't he, a little bit?
Okay. You've met Garank. I take it.
I have.
Then, owing to our duties shared, we are now comrades in arms. I think you've earned this. The power of the Golden Order to aid the hunt of those who live in death.
So he... Enchanted right hand armor, holy damage, okay. Litany of proper death creates image of order to deal holy damage. One of the incantations of the Golden Order fundamentalists, used by hunters of those who live in death. So the Golden Order is a religious organization. And are they the ones crucifying people all over the place? Are those the people up on one that even crosses? They're kind of slight arches, aren't they? Is that who they are? Creates an image of order, dealing holy damage to nearby foes. This incantation is especially damaging to those who live in death. Any felled by this incantation cannot be revived. The role of the hunter is to stamp out defiled reason, all for the perfection of the Golden Order. So it's like a destroy undead spell. And this is a enchant armament held in the right hand with holy affinity attacks. This incantation is especially damaging to those who live in death. Any felled by this incantation can be revived. The role of the hunter is to stamp out defiled reason, all for the perfection of the Golden Order. Okay, so he's got a couple of spells about the...
I serve the Golden Order, that I might put this crooked land to rights, following only the guidance of the Great Elden Ring. Those who live in death fall outside the principles of the Golden Order. Their mere existence sullies the guidance of gold, tainting its truth. And so it is, the vermin must be exterminated, down to the very last.
Okay. Right. I wouldn't mind. Right. I could also... Where was that other... Artist Shack, Gatefront. I'm just trying to think if there's any other merchants. Actually, I'll go to the... I'll go and buy some more spells as well. So that was in the... Okay, front. Here. Yeah. So I'll spend some more ruins with the sorceress.
There you are. Shall we commence the...
Crystal Barrage, yeah, this will... Glintstone Arc, fires a horizontally widening magic arc. Okay, let's buy that. Let's take on this boss again. So I'm just going to keep on trying him. I think I'm... Oh. No. Oh, I've never done that before. Okay. Not what I wanted to do, but fine. I just wanted to... You'll wield my sword. Okay, right. Let's take this guy down. Doing more damage now.
Thou art of passing skill. Warrior blood must truly run in thy veins. Tarnished. Put these foolish ambitions to rest.
Okay. At least got him down to the second phase this time, which was something. So, just getting the timing right on the dodging. I can't miss that many dodges. This might just be a montage of me dying, to be honest. Let's see how it goes. Margit, the Fell Omen. Okay. I'm sort of bait more of those leaping attacks because they're very easy to do. Do you want to leap into me?
Must truly run in thy veins. Tarnished.
Closer. Okay, another attempt. He's tricky, he's just very... I like that attack, I get three hits in.
Thank you.
Oh, I just realized I can use... Cool. I just realized I could use the spirits. Can I summon them here?
Must truly run in thy veins. Tarnished.
get rid of that. Get rid of that. Maybe keep that.
Thou art of passing skill. Warrior blood must truly run in thy veins. Tarnished.
Talisman Pouch.
I shall remember thee, tarnished, smoldering with thy meager flame. Cower in fear of the night. The hands of the fell omen shall brook thee no quarter.
Okay. That was, I mean, I feel like I got it off easy there because I was the using those skeleton militiamen is definitely makes that fight a lot easier, especially because he couldn't really figure out how to necessarily kill them. Okay, and so that was gave him a very, very good distraction. Okay, he gave me a lot of ruins, so maybe I'll level up. So I feel like that was the first big boss, basically, that I've actually defeated, the first kind of non-sort of tutorial-y mini-boss thing. Shall I spin these here? I might go back and buy that keystone for 4,000, the sword keystone for 4,000, and then open that that door, that glowing wall in the basement of the round table room. So that's 4,000, so I could spend, so I could do 1, 2, 3, so I could get 2 levels. I still have enough of that. So I put, it's about 1 in intelligence, 1 in dexterity, and I've still got 4,000 left. Let's poke my nose through here. Okay. So, this castle coming up in a second. Okay, that was good. Round table hold. Very nice. By this. And this is kind of like a pantry. Storeroom. So what is this space? Oh, there's another one. Oh my god, okay, so I opened a door. Gets me halfway into room, but it does have a chest. Okay. Hopefully this is something good. Crepus's black key crossbow. And black key bolts. Okay. See if there's any lore on those. Black crossbow featuring a long stock used for sniping. It has a very long range. Weapon of Crepus, who served the two fingers from the shadows of the Round Table as the Head Confessor. Skill kick. Push an enemy back with a high kick. Effective against enemies who are guarding it can break a first stance. Okay. Crepus. So he's some sort of assassin. Bolts used in Crepus's black key crossbow. An assassin's tool of exquisite craftsmanship. The intricate spiral tip bores deep, injecting a scarlet rot fire into the flesh of its target. Okay, so there are some poisoned bolts. And I need more strength. So maybe I should put some points into strength for this kind of stuff. Okay, well, I mean, I got a cool crossbow for 4,000 runes. That seems fine. Okay, let's continue. Sound of those banners flapping in the wind. That's where I've come from. Oh, so the other tree's kind of inside of it, isn't it? Okay. Right, so let's. What's happened here? Parts of. They've just been ripped to shreds. Parts of this. Huh. Seems I can get down there. Okay. So there's multiple ways through.
You there? Come over here, would you?
You're tarnished, aren't you? I would advise against taking the main gate into the castle. It's tightly guarded by hardened old hands. Try the opening right here. The guards don't know about it. You'll breach the castle undetected. Yes, that's the spirit. You're just the kind of tarnished that I like. I pray for your success. Use that opening to breach the castle. The guards haven't a clue about it. You'll slip right inside undetected. Yes, that's the spirit.
I think I'll also go down this way. A deep moat. So those are just outer curtain walls. Huh. See that. I see you there. I think I now have all of the, well, I don't know if all of the greases, but I have lightning grease, scarlet rot, magically resonant materials, and fire grease. Makes holes like that, sort of some magical attack that's sort of melting. Looks like sort of laser blast or something, doesn't it? This castle was definitely has definitely been savaged. Okay. Can I get back up this way? No, I think I have to go here. Is this sideways enough. Let's get in there. What happens if you tell him you're going to use the main gate?
You're just, I pray for you. Of course, when you approach the gates, I'll signal them to open. It's only your neck on.
Okay.
the gates! Open the gates!
That seems useful. That's very dagger, not just like giant knives. Giant knives grafted onto his legs, I guess that's the point. Everything in here is being grafted together. There's a grace spot. What's put there? Warhawk's Talon. Ooh, okay. And a flight pinion. Is that a weapon? Can I use it? No, it's not a weapon. Okay. A flight pinion. It is a weapon. It's a dex weapon as well. Interesting. And it's quite strong. That's pretty good. Smithing stone, okay. That was worth coming down here for. Stormhawk feather. These feathers enveloped in swirling winds are often used for arrow fletching. Okay, fine. The sword looks pretty good. just gonna. So. It's not gonna do as much damage as this now, though. Showed me. I like that longsword. My ribbons. Okay. They're these guys are pretty cool. They're interesting enemies. Just three of them, wasn't there? Just the three of them, I think. I hope. And now this part of it just feels, you know, this feels very much like a Dark Souls level, whereas the rest of it has felt very different. And so it has become multiple games in one now, at least, anyway. It is quite a big change. Clean. Ooh, applause. Weapon worn on the fist comprised of sharp parallel blades, favored by those who lurk in the dark. Lacerations cause blood loss with great effect. Claw weapons come in pairs, and two-handing this weapon will equip it in both hands. Cool. From a quick step maneuver that allows for circling around. Okay, yep. I'm really interested in this. Weapon as well, because that looks like it does. Compared to everything else, that's 101 plus 24, that's good scaling. It's better scaling than this one is 29, okay. But if this was plus 3, I bet the scaling would be better. And 101, yeah, I mean, if I get that up to plus 3, that'll probably be, and the moveset seems nice as well, it seems very, it's my kind of moveset. Plus it's also light as well. Oh, well, it's the same as the skin of scimitar. So this is lower, but it has bleed. Blood loss by level 16, okay. So I've actually picked up a couple of quite good dexterity weapons, actually. So there's nothing here, is there? No secret walls. Okay. Okay, do I want to try to grab that item? Okay, exploding barrels. Up here, are they friendly or just dispirited? Noticed a item. Also this way. Okay. Throwing dagger, nice. Poison bone dart, okay. An animal bone sharpened a knife for throwing with a poisonless tip, craftable item. Poison short dagger for throwing. It has no handguard. The blade is polished and its weight is expertly balanced. Auxiliary weapon used primarily to constrain an enemy's movements can still be deadly in the right hands. Okay. That's a locked door. Can I see what's inside? Looks like nothing, right? That's also... it's a small room. Maybe it's a staircase or something. Wow, okay, so those holes made it all the way through. And that one, shit. That's so cool. So that hole there, it's bored through from that and still marked the wall. Why didn't that one though? That's the question. And it's like a reliquary of the tree? Okay. Oh. Of course, a trap. Get down here. Omen's garb. Okay, let's read that. Actually, let's go. Garb with a thick embroidered cape attached. Standard wear for the commoners of the land between. Okay, so they're not just not priests like I thought. The board hung from the neck depicts a sprawling tree, its roots and branches forming two holes. This is a self-imposed shackle, a voluntary display of allegiance to the Erd tree that increases faith. Okay. So they're faithful members of the lands between who worship the Erd tree. Erd tree. Come on. See me there? Hey, buddy. Okay, shall I go into that? Go into that doorway this time? They're there. How shall I do this differently though? Could so where can I go next today? Do I have to go through the store anyway? Okay. Should try parrying as well, I guess. Rusty key, okay. Opens locked door in Stormvale Castle. Probably the one downstairs. Curved sword talisman. This could be good. I have a curved sword. Oh, that's right. I got this. Talisman pouch. Small withered bag, knitted by hand, bestowed upon the ruling lord or those attempting to become lord by the elderly finger reader. Finger reader. So what is the stuff about finger reading? I'm not sure. Increases talisman equip slots. As the voices of the two fingers, finger readers are said to live lives internal, and one is even supposed to have served as a wet nurse to royalty. So I still don't know what the two fingers are, if it's a person or a role. This item looks like it's a scrotum. It's a ball sack. Does it just work automatically? Because if so, that's great. And where are my talismans? Okay. A talisman depicting a curved sword and a swordsman enhances guard counters. It is said that a blind swordsman was the originator of this technique, the art of allowing one of its opponents to strike so as to leave them vulnerable to a well-timed reply. Ah, cool. Okay, I will put that on. And I should practice that as well, shouldn't I? So when guarding, strike. Okay. I apologize for cheating you. You're a strong knight, and I did not respect you. I did not treat you with the respect you deserved. Used rusty key. Okay. Yeah, see, now this really feels like a Dark Souls level. I'm even looking around for the next bonfire. Okay. Oh. Okay. Is that jumpable? I guess it is. Is it? Must be, I guess. Brookhammer. Okay, let's look at that. Probably not for me, but probably a strength weapon. 31 strength. Weapon made from ordinary stone brick, wielded by a laborer who led a rebellion and later became a champion himself. Even among other bludgeons of its size, this weapon is especially weighty. The strength of a giant is required to wield it. Barbaric roar. Okay. So, I want to get onto that. Don't think I can from here. Maybe I have to drop down this way. That's a long drop. Okay, let's just... I must be able to get that as well. Oh, no, you can't. To jump onto that and then jump down there. Oh god, okay. No, that's what came up. Item discovery, okay, fine. Is there any lore, actually? So it's all times the need was scraped me. Okay, fine. Those death roots that climbed everywhere as well, perhaps. Mushroom? Okay. Oh god. Still haven't... Still need to find a... some kind of... Not a save point, but... A lost grace would be great right now. Wow. Look at that. That looks interesting. What am I looking at? I'm looking west now. So that's further into Lungrave? Oh no, that's this place here. An island, okay. So where's the Erdtree? It's this way. It must be this way. Stormveil Knights are no joke. Okay. Okay, another try. This time I'll try to treat these knights with a little bit more respect. I was trying to use my counter. See if I can. Okay, that was dangerous. So I don't need to go outside this time. I should just be able to go. Shard. So what is that? A shard of filthy glass, worthless rubbish. Glass shard covered in dirt. Because it sparkles in the light, it might be mistaken for an object of value when seen from afar. It cannot produce light by itself, essentially worthless. Okay. So I can skip the that first night, because I don't know, actually it's not that far to get back to my rooms. Let's just have these. So it's R2. Okay. I'll get that backstabbing. Have I fallen here before? No. Okay. So. Tear leaf. Oh. Okay. I think my ruins might be gone. I think I can kiss them goodbye. That is very effective. Okay. I like this counter now that I've actually figured out how to do it properly. It is, yeah, it's effective. deal with this knight, and then we'll... Almost got him. Almost. And that's a lift, I bet that's a shortcut. Okay. We're learning. We're progressing. Still haven't found any other weapon, armor or clothing that I really can use or... Corner's headband, altered. Focus. Headband with the cloth removed. Standard wear for commoners of the lands between. Only there are no commoners remaining with their wits about them. Okay, so they're all. They're all gone. So frustrating. This is the, what, the 8th time he's killed me? Okay. So, just stay here. I'll back away when he's doing his big swing. Absolutely goblin mode. It is annoying. Withered straight sword. Straight sword with a rather short but wide blade, simple to wield, was known as the sword of the people. Though the Erd Tree starting is still visible, time has not been kind to the sword, now merely a shadow of its former self. So, the Erd Tree, the religion, the worship of it. Ooh. So, what's the relationship, I wonder, between the Erdtree and the Golden Order? Is that... they believe that the Erdtree is... they worship the Erdtree? They're just maintaining its... Oh. I want to get this first backstab in. ₹400 for that, for the night that took me 7 or 8 attempts, or like 10 times. What are they making here? They're making ballistas. It's a windlass for a large crossbow, I think. And some kind of cannon in the shape of a dragon. Eagle doors. Are they just... they're like the sides of boxes or something. Okay, now. How about we have a shortcut? So I've come all the way to the top, looking for a shortcut. There's something behind me. It's just a guy with a crossbow. Should be able to go around behind him, I think. He should be just... is he there? Oh, Okay, I see some boxes that look suspicious on that side, so can I break them? No. I can also go out here, but I'm worried about getting attacked by eagles, amongst other things. Exilehood. Ooh, that's cool. That's... Yeah, come and have a go. Should not let the guy blow his horn. One flask left. Okay, so and there's nothing out here? That cannot be. This is all a dead end? What's this way? Such a nice little room. Feels very cozy. Okay, so there's many. Many what look like shortcuts to me, all inactive. I forget that you can jump so easily in this game. Drawstring, fire grease. Oh, okay. Does that mean you can add? Extra considering material quickly coats on inflicting fire damage, but with a brief effect owing to a small size. Oh, okay, so these are a brief, a short time, a brief effect, because they're smaller. Okay. There's our knight. Go upstairs. So, we kind of established this was a dead end, so let's go down. And this way. I could have saved myself a lot of stress if I just went into this room first. Right. Okay. This... Can I... sneak up on this bird? I'd like to get to behind it. Okay. Oh, it's dragging. Okay. I mean, they're not that bad. They're just terrifying. And this is the same one. So, it's a bird with swords grafted to its legs, and then they're stuck into an exploding barrel, and it's going to fly around with it. Next level. Okay. That is some wild character design, or enemy design, I should say. Okay, I came up there. So, we're getting to the top of this battlement. Which is pretty cool. Attack. I'm so glad I got that sword off it. I'm to some concerns. I'm very tempted to go and upgrade that sword. Because I'm not really a fan of the scimitar anyway. Oh god, okay, so now we're going to this tower. This is the way forward, I guess so. Big knights. Is this the front gate? It is, isn't it? I mean, that looks horrible to get through. I'm going to go back to the round table. And try upgrading that sword. And then I might call this episode, because it's going to be very long otherwise.
Well, I took you for dead. No matter, it's all the same. Lay out your arm.
Warhawk's Talon. Smithing Stone 1. So what do we have if we don't have equipment? So we need Smithing Stone 1 for this, which we don't have any of, and we've got Smithing Stone 2. Okay, let's look at our inventory. Smithing Stone 2 and 3, okay. In that case, let's go back into the Limgrave Tables and do a little bit of grinding, but okay. I'm gonna end this episode here while I do some grinding in these tunnels. We defeated that fell Margit and made our way into the castle, which is a really nice Dark Souls level, basically, as far as I can see. So thanks for watching. Hopefully you'll see the next one as well. Thanks very much.